to hear some words with us here at Belgium-based defender Sheldon Bateau and Hughtun Hector. You have represented the country for some time and you have worked in this tournament. Team has been able to talk to you. Tell us how you felt about it.
I felt great about it. I mean, from day one, I think it was our goal to top the group, you know. We work hard. With my game, I think I did well. I saw that the coach had confidence in me to bring me back into the team, you know. So, on top of it, I think the whole team performed well, and it's just to take it into the next round, and we have a strong group to go all out and win the tournament. Yeah.
Great, the Sheldon seem to be good for him, that Germany be able to transfer that international team. What do you think about this one?
I thought we had a fairly good performance. You know, a young team, one or two experienced players, Jones, also a lot of youth with experience like myself. You know, and yeah, so far I have two goals for the season. And yeah, I tried to lead from the back. Although not wearing the armband, but trying to be a leader by myself, you know, and yeah, just trying to keep a good spirit within the team, and I thought we sort of it.
Open question for you guys.
Sheldon, what does it mean to you mentally to get to play three games at centre-back successively after playing so much at full-back?
It was a bit difficult. You know, with the change in climate, it wasn't easy at all. You know, and mentally I thought that I would get some rest the last game. You know, but yeah, it wasn't so. But yeah, I was ready to do a job for the team and my country. You know, and I tried to give 100% every game, and yeah, it was successful.
Are you much more comfortable playing in central defence as opposed to at left or right back?
Yeah, for sure. Central defence, you know, I have more time. I see the game better. You know, I can make infiltrations through the middle. You know, and I think it's my best position.
Go ahead.
I think it was a sense of leadership. You know, I think the coach felt that he needed me for every game. You know, because normally the last game I should have been substituted, but yeah, we had some difficulties in the end. You know, so yeah. I thought it was a bit difficult to make substitutions. So, yeah, like I say, I was really mentally to do a job for the team.
Hector, it's been a while since you were with the team, and I know you had your doubts about, you know, if you would be used and so on. Was there a special motivation for you in this tournament?
Yeah, my motivation was to represent my national team, you know, to come out and do well, you know. To help Trinidad and Tobago advance from this group. We advance now, it's time to take it into the next group. I think we need to come out and look harder, because I know the next group will be more difficult, you know. So I think my biggest motivation is to come and help Trinidad and Tobago win the Digital Cup.
After Mr. Anthony Gold Cup and so on, did you feel as if you had something to prove in this tournament?
Yeah. I think getting 1 year for the World Cup was a big disappointment for me, you know. The league in Vietnam was still running, they didn't take any break, and the push was a problem for him sending us back home to play in the World Cup. So it was a big disappointment for me, but I tried to keep my head on and wait for the next opportunity to represent Trinidad and Tobago, I think. And I start from here. You know, I talked to the coach and he said he won't do it until we go to the next World Cup qualifier, and he said I will play a big part in leading the team from here on. So, you know, it's just to keep focus and look hard and keep going.
No. What would happen if we do go to the next World Cup, and again it's in July? What is it that you think you'd make then?
Yeah, well, this time I work with a different club now, so things will be much different. I think that all the players will go back to the national teams and stuff, so I think it will be more different now.
Go ahead.
How have you been in Vietnam, life in Vietnam?
Ah, the life is very good in Vietnam, you know. Many people say, to look at Vietnam to fight war, you know, but it's not like that. It's more developed now. I mean, the city, other cities, you know, which part I stay in is very good, comfortable. Food-wise, I think was a problem at first, you know, but now I'm comfortable with the food. I go to hotels or restaurants and eat, so it could be decent, you know.
And language barriers?
The language is very difficult. I try to learn certain things, you know, the little things, you know, but very difficult to learn Vietnamese language.
Can you speak any Vietnamese?
Huh?
Can you speak Vietnamese?
Not really. Just small words, you know, like dance, love you.
What was your favorite dish in Vietnam? Was your favorite dish in Vietnam? Was it like?
Vietnam, my favorite dish in Vietnam is pho bò. It's like noodles, you know, like one soup, noodles and that vegetables and very nice.
Yeah. So tell us about the club's name.
I never really asked what the TMT stands for, but 10 people asked me this, but I just know that I have a TMT.
I think Belgium is a well-known country, you know, well-developed, you know, and yeah, Cully Highland is there also, so yeah, sometimes I feel at home, you know, so yeah, for me it's no big difference, you know, sometimes I cook to feel like I'm in Trini, sundae, cook pie, big chicken, everything. So for me sometimes he's like home. Yeah, he can speak a bit Trinidad, but they're learning, still learning.
Are you in contact with Elton John and Villarreal over there? Could you say a little bit about what's happening with those players?
Yeah, saw them two times. It was a bit difficult because they live like 1.5 away. You know, but I saw one game at that time. Plaza and Winchester was still there. You know, but yeah, like I said, it was a bit difficult because of the games I had. I had 3 games in 7 days, so to go there was really difficult.
Do you know much about what's happening there?
Not much. No.
Sheldon, what do you have to say to some of the under 20 players who are the reports of them coming to the production as well? What do you have to say to them?
Well, the day I came in, I saw them at the airport, you know, and I wished them luck, you know, and I told them to be confident, you know, everyone is the same one, you know, it's all about doing what you can do. And yeah, I told them that I'll be back soon, so just to hold out until I come back to make them feel as comfortable as possible, you know, and yeah, it's good that players started to go out, you know, because since I went to Mecca, they've been asking for another battle, you know, so they came recently and it's good that they saw some good potential in this game.
Further questions? Just a final question from me. You know, you guys are quite close to some of our national women team players. They start their campaign on Wednesday. Any words of well wishes for them before they do well?
I want to wish them a lot of success. You know, I saw it was a difficult time for them. It was really sad to see what they had to go through. You know, but yeah, it's a difficult time in our football. You know, but at the end of the day, they need to put it aside and go to the field and show that they deserve the support, show that they deserve what they're asking for. You know, so like I say, I wish them luck and a lot of success.
Alright, gentlemen, thank you so much and I'll see you in November.